Welcome to part two. Now, in the first episode of this series, I told you that the handshake kaput finished. Okay? Number two, politically, General Miguna moves from being a giant, a small giant, to a huge giant politically. Okay? In deporting Miguna the first time, the government created a monster that it shall forever live to regret doing. Yeah? Now, yesterday, in attempting to deport Miguna for the second time, they created a monster 100 times larger, yeah, 100 times more ferocious, 100 times more deadly, more effective, etc., etc., than they did on February 6th, the first time they deported Miguna. The international media houses that could not touch Miguna before will now be looking for him like never before, yeah? Those who believed before that Miguna was not the right kind of political figure, that is too abrasive, too aggressive, is not polished as a politician, yeah? Those people now have changed their position. Na wameingia box kabisa. In other words, they have joined Miguna's supporters, yeah? That means more power to Miguna. Much more power to Miguna. Number three, and this one saddens me very much, and this one a lot of you will not take very well, but it is a fact and I have to say it. Number three, the career, the long, illustrious career of one Raila Odinga, finished. Now, Raila Odinga has done some magic before. Yeah, he has come back when people have said there's no way he can come back. Okay? And indeed, I know in this case he'll make a spirited effort to try and come back, yeah? But I believe that will be a mission impossible. And his biggest problem is the fact that the agreement, whatever deal he had with Uhuru, was secret. So whatever he tells us now was in the deal, whatever he tells us now that was in the agreement he had with Uhuru, which is now dead in the water, it will be very hard for anybody to believe. What will be more believable is that he must have made the arrangement for a selfish interest. Because the question he'll never be able to answer is that if indeed he made the agreement for the good of Kenyans, why was not the good of just one Kenyan, Miguna, not served at the airport yesterday? That'll be an impossible question for him to answer. And if he says Uhuru conned him, Uhuru fooled him, that's even worse. Because the vast majority of Kenyans will tell him to his face, "We told you so." Yeah. Indeed, I consider myself very lucky because had I not changed my position barely 2-3 days ago, yeah, over that handshake, I would also now be facing, yeah, a barrage of people telling me, "We told you so. We told you that Raila was conned. We told you that the handshake was really not there." And indeed, many people still tell me the same, despite what I did 2 or 3 days ago. And of course, they will have every reason to do so. They'll be justified in telling me, "Chris, we told you so. Yeah, you told us this about the handshake. We told you." Yeah. And folks, let's call a spade a spade. Let's speak the truth. I will have no answer. Okay? Now, that is me. Now, you imagine Raila Odinga. What can he say? Overturn, overturn, overturn. Raila Odinga politically kaput. Gone. His appearance at the airport, as I've already said, yeah, was part of his comeback plan. Okay? But it was too little, too late, in my view. It will not work. It will never work. Because even, let's just humor ourselves for a minute and say, okay, fine. He has come back, he's out of the handshake, he's back to where he was before. Really? What is he coming back to? He's coming back to NASA? Well, I would like to hear what Kalonzo Musyoka has to say about that. Or let alone Kalonzo Musyoka, I would like to hear what Moses Wetangula has to say about that. I would like to hear what Musalia Mudavadi has to say about that. Actually, the only play left for Raila, Wetangula, etc., etc., all the rest, the only play left is for them to rally behind Miguna Miguna. To accept to be led by Miguna Miguna. Because in all this drama, Miguna Miguna clearly was the only person who still had his eyes wide open. Now I'm speaking purely politically, not emotionally, not trying to support anybody. Yeah, you all of you know my position with Miguna Miguna. Yeah, I don't like him. Yeah, personally, I'm just talking about my personal feelings and views. I don't like the way he does things. However, I don't have to like him. This is politics. I do commentaries, I analyze politics, and a lot of times I'm talking about people I don't like. But that's irrelevant. Miguna is now the real general. Miguna is now the leader of the opposition. If anybody wants to play any opposition politics, you have to consult Miguna. You have to be in Miguna's camp to have any semblance of support. It's just as simple as that. And that includes Raila Odinga. Yeah, and yesterday he made the first step towards that, yeah, by going to the airport to do something he knew that he would not be able to do, but for sure to show the world that he's behind Miguna Miguna, because up to this point he has done nothing, yeah, to show us that he supports NRM. He has done nothing to show us that he supports what Miguna Miguna is doing. Indeed, the feeling many Kenyans have gotten is that Raila is against Miguna. Yeah, hey, how politics changes. That, my friends, is definitely yet another overturn. Overturn, overturn, overturn. And it shall be no more. That is exactly where we're headed. Indeed, that is already where we are. Okay, now let's quickly shift to the government side. After the drama of yesterday, what does the government do next? Apologize? Even if they had the courage to do that, it's not enough. It is like a situation whereby you go and you butcher a person, you kill them, and then you cut their body into small pieces. Okay? And then now you come back and you apologize. There are some things you cannot apologize. Yeah, it is not possible. No matter how many million apologies you send, no matter what you do, you cannot just get away from them. Now, what happened yesterday at the airport is one of those incidents. Yeah. Therefore, even the government overturned. Whatever the government says, whatever statement they issue, will not work. Politically, it will not work. Put yourselves for a minute in the shoes of one DP William Ruto. Yeah, he's very good at coming up with statements that make excuses. What would you honestly tell the people? What would you honestly say to explain yourself for what happened yesterday? Yeah, and there's something called collective responsibility. What was done to Miguna yesterday was done by a few goons supported by the, we are told, almost 400, yeah, policemen, recce squad, yeah, heavily armed policemen. But those people were taking orders. They were operating under orders, yeah. Orders from where? Orders from NASA? No. Orders from ODM? Nope. Orders from the government of the Republic of Kenya. Therefore, it is a government. Now, how do you explain what happened yesterday? How? It is impossible. Okay? Now, that brings us to another very important point, the crux of this whole problem. Okay? And I'll tell you very bluntly what is happening here. For a very long time now, I've been telling members of Club 1999 that actually there's somebody who is more powerful than the president. Okay? There are people, there's a group of wazees who are more powerful than the president. Yeah? And they're able to make orders, do things, yeah, which leaves the president's hands tied. That's really what it is. Now, these people from the 60s, from the 70s, came out yesterday and gave their orders. Okay? And they gave those orders relying on the laws that were in place in the 60s and 70s, yeah, even the international laws. They gave those orders assuming that what could happen and what was possible in the 60s and 70s is also possible in the year 2018. That's really what it was. But now that the human waste has hit the fan, yeah, guess who has that stuff on their face? It's the government. Yeah, it is the government that now has to sort out the mess. But unfortunately, this mess cannot be sorted out. Bottom line, whatever little legitimacy this government has is gone, kaput, finished. Now, if you have no idea about the identity of the people I'm talking about, yeah, actually there are three or four people, yeah, the answer is in my notes next to this video in Club 1999. Yeah, I spell it out there in clear black and white. Now, this is important to note. Yesterday at the airport, what happened, is that there were some goons, leading the operation. These people were in plain clothes, And if you looked at these people, you would not believe they were policemen, okay? And indeed, I believe they were not policemen, They were just goons, Goons sent by these very powerful people. Goons that these very powerful people trust. And they had very, very strict orders. And these goons have the same emotions running through them as these people who sent them. Now, if it was possible to repair this damage, what I'd have said, will the real president of the Republic of Kenya stand up, please, so that we know who it is? Yeah? Because it's a bit hazy. But we have long crossed that bridge. Yeah? That statement I cannot make because it's too late now. Damage done, damage irreparable. There are very many things which are going to unfold in the next few hours and the next few days, But I can tell you one thing for sure, to convince you that the government is finished, Remove yourself from Kenya for a minute. Pretend you're not a Kenyan. Pretend you're observing all this from outside, What would your view be of any government that sides with the Kenyan government after what happened at the airport yesterday? And I'm not talking about a government coming out and supporting what happened. I'm simply saying a government coming out and saying, we are behind you. We want to help you to sort out this mess. What would you think of such a government? You'd put them in the same basket as the savages we saw running around the airport yesterday. 400, 500 people there to forcibly evict somebody, a citizen of that country, from their country. And in the process, breaking every known and unknown international law. And in the process, crossing every known and unknown boundary. And I'm not even talking about legal boundaries. Those they crossed, very many of them. I'm talking about boundaries in the behavior of the human species. Folks, the only thing left, the only thing that can wash, the only thing that can try at least to have some semblance of repairing this damage is for Uhuru Kenyatta and William Ruto to resign, leave office. That is the only thing. Nothing else will work. Now, indeed, I know they're not going to resign. Indeed, I know they're going to make every effort to try and repair what happened yesterday. But I put it to you, it will not work. Overturn, overturn, overturn. Kaput. Finished, gone. That's really what it is. Hiyo popcorn ilisha ama bado iko? Pass around the popcorn. And some juice as well. No alcohol. Because you need to be very, very sober to observe what is happening. And what is going to happen in the next few hours and days. Because if you're taking anything alcoholic, what is most probably going to happen is that you're going to observe what is happening. Then you're going to look at the drink you're drinking and wonder, "Aye, has somebody put something in this thing I'm drinking?" And so you need to be stone sober, to believe that what actually you're observing is actually happening. And that actually you're not dreaming, it is reality. That is really what it is, folks. Now, some time back I said that things are going to happen in Kenya, and you're going to see these things on CNN, international media houses, respectable, Al Jazeera, It's not going to be the kind of thing that is broken on the Kumekucha channel. Then you'll say, oh, Chris manufactured this, or some other obscure website, where you say this is fake news. No. It's going to be on live television. And I believe it is possible to fake live television, but this will not be fake. It will be impossible. Indeed, it is impossible to fake live television of the most respected international media houses. You switch to CNN, you see it. You switch to Al Jazeera, you see it. You switch to BBC, you see it. That cannot be fake. It is happening. God help Kenya. God remember mercy for Kenya. In your wrath, dear Lord, remember the innocents. Spare the innocents, Lord. Mwenyezi Mungu, tafadhali kumbuka wanyonge. Wale wajiwezi. As much as possible, dear Lord, remember the weak, the innocents, the poor. Yeah, even as you rescue the long-suffering Kenyans, remember mercy, Lord. Until next time, this is Chris Kumekucha. Kenya inchi, yangu Kenya inchi, yangu ilio. Kenya inchi yangu, Kenya inchi.